Episode 1462, Where Does the Time Go?
It's time to train for life and love your journey. In this episode of Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie, you'll learn new ways to rediscover, rejuvenate, and renew your mind, body, and spirit. Please welcome your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo. Staring at a stop
sign, watching people happy, happy day. You made it. It is Friday, and I got to tell you, I have had a really long week. How about you? Have you been able to keep your feet on the ground and your head on your shoulders, or do you feel like you're running in all different directions? Where does the time go? It's Confessions of an Upset Mama. Let's dive in. For those of you who are brand new to Create You Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you already had the opportunity, you'll want to head on over to createyournow.com where you can learn more and sign up for the Kisses newsletter, the Keep It Simple Strategy, Everyday Solutions to Live, Love, and Impact. Well, how unfair is it when you are wanting to give your family everything only to be left with little time at the end of the day? Where does the time go? You give all of yourself making sure to keep the routine and structure of a day to be productive as a woman, a wife, as a mom, a CEO of your business. But you're there going, I just didn't get it all done. And you feel guilty. That's real life for us, isn't it? Come on, it's confession day. Be real with yourself because it's refreshing when we let it all loose. Let it hang out. It's okay. You're safe here. You know those moments when you are consumed by what your children are doing throughout the day? You pause just long enough to inhale very slowly, hoping to slow down time. Where does the time go? How is it that you trying to be the best mother that you can be makes you feel more like coming in last place for a contest you didn't even enter? This mom thing is very complicated the more you immerse yourself in it. It doesn't seem fair that you have to pick and choose your children over your business, your children over your spouse, your children over me time, your children over a clean house, your children over a better car. We could go on and on and on. I'm sure you have about 15 things to add to that list. Then all you hear around you buzzing about, right, all these little buzzwords, is how successful all of these other mothers are. So what's your problem? Why can't you get your act together? Why can't you organize better? Why can't you make decisions better? Because if you could do all of that right, you wouldn't be wondering about how the day has escaped you. Where does the time go? As children, time is in the moment. There is never worry or concern about what is going to happen during tax season. Yeah, you heard it here first. Can you believe it? Taxes are around the corner. I know that's the last thing you wanted to hear is money talk, but it's true. When are you going to schedule your vacation this year? Do you think the kids think about that? No. They're just like, Mom, when are we going? Isn't it almost the end of the school year so we can go on vacation? That's their thought process. All they experience is the day in which they are present. Yes, there is some planning in their minds as to what's to come, but their what's to come is no further than following that next moment. You know, think about it this way. Why do you think children are so surprised when it's the big event like vacation? Yesterday, it was so far away for them to live in reality, right? They just couldn't touch it. It was too far away. And remember that repetitive question, driving on the long road trip? Are we there yet? 10 minutes later, are we there yet? They are simply present in the moment. That 10 minutes seems like 8 hours to them. Conscious of the time they see, which is what is right in front of them. Now, as we get older and as they get older, right, we have to learn what? To plan ahead. It's part of a survival mode when you become an adult. This adulting thing, I don't know about you, but I'm still learning it. And it becomes a greater challenge. Our children are thrown into planning for the future after living the majority of their lives in the moment. Think about that. We ask our children to be children, to see things new every single day. They grow up and they experience things for the first time. And then after we've already gone through our adulting initially, and now we're raising up these children, they're getting old enough now to become adulters, you know, they're adulting in the world, so to speak. And all of a sudden, they've always been living in the moment, and now they're asked to plan for their future, and they're like, I don't know how to get there. And you wonder why it takes some of our children 15 to 20 years to get their feet on the ground. So there you are, questioning what you have accomplished for the day. Surely I should have been able to do more. Why couldn't I have gotten it all done? What's wrong with me? Where does the time go? This is where we as adults can learn from children. Let tomorrow worry about itself. Be present today. That is your Kiss the Keep It Simple strategy. Let tomorrow worry about itself. Be present today. Matthew 6, verse 34 says, therefore, do not worry about tomorrow, for tomorrow will worry about itself. Each day has enough trouble of its own. I'm not saying you're not planning too far ahead, that you shouldn't schedule things out. That's not what I'm saying at all. What I'm saying is that we get ourselves immersed in the worry, the concern of, oh, I've got to get all of this done by this time. And then when you stop during that day going, okay, I'm looking at my to-do list and my to-do list only has two check marks on it. And I've got like 12 other items on there. I feel like a failure. You're not a failure. Time is still moving at the same tempo it was when you were a child. The difference is where your eyes see now. We plan things out further. Let me take you a little bit deeper. Why do you think God doesn't give you your whole life's plan when you're young? He could reveal that to you at the age of 2. He could reveal it to you at the age of 10. He could have given it to you at the age of 18 or 21, whenever we decided that, now as a human being, you are an adult and you can handle exactly what's going to happen in your life. The thing is we can't handle it. We barely can make it through the day without worrying about tomorrow. Let tomorrow worry about itself. Be present today. There is no reason to beat yourself up because the clock is ticking faster than you think it should. The tempo is the same as when you were 2 years old and now that you're 42 years old or 72 years old or 102 years old. It's the way we see it that's different. I know, pretty heavy for a Friday confession day, but one I think is very important. Why? Because we are looking at planning out our future for the year of 2019 or whatever year you're celebrating. Right now, if you're listening to it, it's January 11th of 2019. Maybe you're 2 weeks behind this date. Maybe you're 2 or 3 years behind this. Whatever it is, this is applicable to your life. That's why we call it confessions. It's life application. So if you're going to let tomorrow worry about itself and be present today, what does it look like? Number one, structure your day focusing on the moment. This way, the worry will fade a little, allowing you to accomplish more. Now, I'm not going to say that the worry is going to fade completely, because we can get in our own minds, can't we? You know, and we're not going to get into that because that's for a whole nother episode. But your mind can be distracted. Don't let it be distracted. Structure your day focusing on the moment. Don't let it focus on that second hand that keeps ticking by on the clock. Number two, construct routines that support the flow of your day. If you're looking at your day going, okay, I know this is my year to really hone in on being healthy. This is my year to kind of take the kiddos' activities and pare them down a little bit. Having 3 children, maybe I shouldn't have them in 5 or 6 different activities. I want to plan out our vacation a little bit more because I want to remove extra stressors. So you're beginning to look at what routines for the new year. So construct those routines to support the day. If you're saying, okay, I want to work out, but you know your afternoon and evenings are going to be filled with activities of your 3 children, then guess what? You probably need to get up earlier in the morning. Yes, I know that may mean an extra 30 minutes before you normally get up, which means you need to go to bed 30 minutes earlier and be sleeping so your body can rest and restore. But by doing so, what? You're taking out the craziness that you will feel at the end of the day, standing in the middle going, where does the time go? Number 3, simplify by being present in whatever you do. This is a tough one. A lot of us say, I'm there. I'm already present. I get that. Try this activity. I want you to find a chair. Now, you may not be able to find a chair this second, but if you can do it right now. I want you to find a chair. I just want you to sit in that chair. It can be a dining room chair. It can be a recliner chair. But I want you to sit in that chair. And I want you to let your feet actually touch the floor so you're balanced nicely, okay? And then I want your arms to rest gently wherever it's comfortable. So if they have armrest, then put them on there. If there aren't any armrest on the chair, then you can lay your hands in your lap, or if you want to sit on them, whatever it is that makes you comfortable in that chair. Now, the key is this. I want you to breathe deeply. I don't want you to be distracted by any other sounds around you yet. What I want you to do is focus on your breathing. I want you to hear your breaths. And as you breathe, I want you to melt into your chair. I literally want you to become so relaxed that you are one with that chair. And that means that if someone came up to you and scooted in the chair, you would be so one with that chair that it would be like you're just going with the chair, not against the chair. Most of us go against our day. We go against time. We're always working against something. You need to learn to be present in the moment and go with it. So simplify by being present in whatever you do. Take it from the kid's life book. Let the distraction appear when you show up in that moment. So as things happen and unravel in your life, maybe you're going to the football game and all of a sudden, I know football season's over, but you know my love for football. We still got the Super Bowl ahead, so I can still talk a little bit more football. But let's say you're going off to that football game and you get there and all of a sudden you're like, oh my gosh, I forgot the snacks. And you're just like crushed. I mean, already I can feel, whew, it just is this wash over. You know what it's like, don't you? Yeah, we've all been there. And you feel so guilty all of a sudden. And then immediately in your mind, you're going, where's the closest grocery store or convenience store? How long is it going to take me to get there? Will I be able to get back in time before the game starts? Or at least be able to watch a little bit of it, go right before halftime so I can have the snacks for them during halftime? Breathe. Let the distraction appear when you show up in that moment. Why? Because you'll be able to handle it better. Simplify by being present in whatever you do. Construct routines that support the flow of your day and structure your day focusing on the moment. Time is actually on your side when you don't get flustered in the moment when you feel out of control. That's ultimately our issue. Where does the time go? We're upset because we feel like we've lost control. That whole to-do list that should have gotten accomplished, well, I only got one check mark of 7 on there. And that's not good for me. So now what do I do? Well, now you feel like what you've lost control. And now the 7, right, that was there, you only have 1 off. That means 6 has to carry over what? To the next day. And you're like, but on that day, I already have 5. And it doesn't include any of the 6 that are left over. You add that up, you're to 13. You're like, this is not fair. Actually, it's 12. 6 plus 6 is 12, or whatever my numbers are. Okay, it's late in my brain. You get the idea, right? Because you feel what? Out of control. Where does the time go? And I got a bonus for you. When life happens and you haven't planned accordingly, go with the flow. This is so hard for all of us. I know for me, this is one of my strengths. Strut your flexible feathers. I love that. Yes, I want you to be the peacock that struts your flexible feathers. You got to go with the flow sometimes. You don't always have to be in control. You can make changes on the fly and survive. You're not going to drown when you feel like you don't have everything done off of your list or if something's forgotten. Breathe. It's okay. Strut your flexible feathers. It's important. And I promise you, you'll stand taller for it. Now, I get that this year is a pivotal year for you. Because you're looking at your year going, I already have 3 to 4 goals that I want to accomplish. And then I have 3 or 4 for my family. By the time you start looking at it, you're looking at 7 to 10 goals for everyone. That's a lot to hold what? Responsibility for. So if you're one who's saying, okay, time management, structure. I don't know what that looks like. I really like control, and it's a hard thing for me to give up control in a positive way. There are some things that we shouldn't give up control on, but that's for another episode. But in what we're talking about here in time, we can give up control and still survive with a smile on our face. There's no reason to stress out. But if you're stressing out about it, click on the link, take AIM in the show notes. That will begin our conversation. I have a free gift for you. It's a coaching call with me. Yes, you can have a free complimentary coaching call, but it takes you to take action. So click on that link, take AIM in the show notes. Action ignites motivation. And that will begin our conversation. What do you want your family's life to look like? When you look back in the next 1 month, we're not going back out a year. We're just talking about 1 month. That's 4 weeks. Did you know that this is January 11th? And that means in 4 days, it's January 15th. Are you freaking out yet? I know I was. In fact, I was having the conversation when I was in Walmart with the gal who was checking me out. And I said, do you realize, and this was a couple days ago, I asked her, I said, did you realize that we're almost to mid-January? That means we're less than 11 months and we're going to be decorating again. And I thought in my mind, I love Christmas. Can I just leave my Christmas decorations up? Even though my husband's like, sweetheart, it's time to take him down. I'm like, but I had a late start. I really like them. And the kids like them too. And it makes the house so warm. But again, where does the time go? Time goes as fast as it was when you were 2 and when you're 42, 72, or 102. It's how you choose to use it. Are you going to get lost in your control? Or are you going to step back and let tomorrow worry about itself? Be present. Be incredible. Be you. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. Have a fabulous weekend. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life, and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.